Men jag är i alla fall fri nu och kan därför plocka in kvällens första gäst. Det ska bli så roligt. Hennes debutskiva kom på tredje plats över de mest sålda skivorna i USA förra året. Igår kväll hade hon konsert här i Stockholm. Nu är hon här, direkt från Kanada, bara 19 år gammal. Avril Lavigne! Avril, oh, you're gonna sit like that? I'll sit like that as well.
Gotta be comfortable. Right.
Okay. You're from Canada, right?
Yeah.
Okay. And this is Sweden. Do you know anything about Sweden?
Not really.
No? Because there are a lot of similarities between Canada and Sweden. We have the climate that's pretty much the same.
Yeah, it's really cold here.
It's cold. And does it get as dark in Canada as in here?
I think so, yeah.
Mm-hmm. And then we have the hockey.
Right, yeah. Right? We're big on hockey in Canada. Yeah? I grew up playing it.
You grew up playing it as well?
Started like doing ice hockey when I was like pond hockey actually.
Pond hockey?
My dad brought me up.
What is that? Pond, like on a lake?
In the wintertime, in the backfield, we'd play hockey.
Okay.
Play hockey with my brother. And then when I got older, I joined a team.
Oh, so you actually played on a team as well? What position?
I played right wing and center.
Both at the same time?
Not at the same time, I just switched, but
what was the name of the team?
My first hockey team was Beaver Lumber. It was house league, so it was like sponsored by like a business or whatever.
Who was called Beaver Lumber?
Beaver Lumber was, yeah.
Beaver as in Beaver the animal?
Yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. It was like a wood company or something, but when I got into high school, I made the girls team for 2 years in a row.
Oh, so you played hockey that long, into high school?
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Mm-hmm. Why did you quit?
I didn't really quit. I left school, so, I'm sure if I lived at home, I'd probably still be playing.
You think so?
Mm-hmm.
I thought hockey players had to be real big and fat.
Well, it helps, I guess, to be taller, but... Also, if you're smaller, you're faster, and you can get around the puck.
Therefore,
you know,
the right wing position.
A lot more. But well, I played on the guys' team up until Pee Wee, which is a league, and that was like when you entered body contact, and like I was like the only girl, so my dad wouldn't let me play.
I understand that, because you were flying across the ice.
Yeah.
They were tracking you. Did you ever get real, real hurt?
No. The only thing that happened, one time I stopped breathing, but...
That's not good.
That's about it. I ended up...
Why did you stop breathing?
I don't know what happened. I think I got this stick went in my stomach or something.
Okay. Like, oh, and you just lost
your
breath.
Knocked the wind out of me. I got hurt a lot, but nothing too major. I got in a lot of fights.
Yeah, I heard that. You even beat up a goalie.
Yeah.
Why did you do that?
You can still work the puck and try to get it in the net until the whistle blows. And the whistle didn't blow, so I was like still trying to get it in the net. And then when the whistle got blown, I stopped. Yeah. And he just like punched me, and it was a guy. And like, so I threw him into the net, and then I'm laying down in the net. We're both in like the net fighting each other, and my dad has it on video camera.
Oh, he has it on video camera?
Yeah.
You should bring that along
I
next
know.
Time.
I know.
Okay, did you get a penalty for that?
Probably.
Okay, you don't remember. That's when you lost your air.
But because I was like the only chick on the ice, all the guys would like on the other team would like pick on me, and they'd skate behind me and like start like hacking me with their stick and stuff.
That's
and,
so like, immature.
And I'd turn around and like punch them or something.
You would do that?
Yeah.
Okay.
But
how did that work? I mean, as the only girl on a guy's team, you must have thought about that before you asked if you could join the team.
Well. I don't know, I was just like used to always being around guys and stuff. There was one other girl in the league, and like I remember like she would always, me and her would always like fight because like we were the only girls or whatever, but that's what hockey basically is like, just a really aggressive sport in fighting. Mm-hmm. It's kind of, you
it's
know,
more
it
like
can
that
get,
in America than in Sweden.
It can really, mm. It can, you know. It can
did you
get,
kick her ass?
Actually, off the ice, I did.
Oh.
I remember throwing her into a garbage can.
Into a garbage can?
Yeah.
Okay, good for you. So where did you get the idea to quit hockey and start playing music?
Well, I didn't really stop playing hockey until I left home, but I d- did both. I played hockey and sang, but I got my start like in church.
That's where. In church?
Yeah, I sang my first solo in church.
So are you like a Christian or?
I'm not like a hardcore religious person, but I
You don't seem like it.
I come from, you know, Christian background, was brought up, raised in a Christian home and stuff. But
And did they make you sing in church or was that your own idea?
I was raised in church and that's where I heard music and I was just like, hey, I want to be up on stage singing like everybody.
Complicated.
No. I want to be up on stage singing too, so because I saw everyone singing all the time, so that's just where I started and kind of branched out from church and started singing just around town at fairs and like stuff like that.
But what did you sing? Did you sing like the gospel songs?
I would sing the gospel songs in church. And then actually when I started singing outside of church, my parents still had me singing the gospel songs. And then I was kind of like, Mom, Dad, can I like do something else? I felt a little bit uncomfortable because people just kind of like, I was just, I don't know, it was cool, but I kind of wanted to do secular music outside of church. So I was just so young that they kind of, gave me songs, soundtracks, and went out and picked the nice songs like the Faith Hill songs and and like some Shania Twain and Sam McLaughlin and stuff like that.
Okay. Do you remember one of the first songs you sang in church? Can you sing us a bit from that now?
No, I can't remember.
Okay.
It was some Christmas.
Christmas song.
Song, yeah.
Okay.
But.
All right, we'll skip that. Let's. You have a new single out here in Sweden from your big success album that's called Let Go. Let's just take a short look at the video for that. You could just introduce that for us.
I'm With You is just about not having a guy and kind of feeling really lonely and
okay, a sad song.
Yeah.
A bit of a sad song. Let's take a look at that.
Won't somebody come take me home? It's that damn cold night. Trying to figure out.
All right. Avril. Avril. Is that the man? Avril. That's your third single, I'm With You. A lonely song about losing a guy. Oh, do you have a boyfriend now?
Mm-mm.
No. Okay. Do you want to have a boyfriend?
I don't care.
You don't care?
No.
Okay. So much for that. But I mean, you seem to be very busy now. This album was released last year, and it's so like millions of copies only in the United States, the third most selling album in the United States. And I guess you've been touring and promoting this every day since then.
Yeah, I've been doing promo for like, I think like 10 months.
Okay. And aren't you tired of this?
Yeah.
No,
I'm not tired of this.
No, I mean this touring.
It's kind of just the promo part, but yesterday was like our third show, so I'm glad to be touring finally and just not doing promo.
That's nice.
I mean, I still am doing promo, but just now that I'm finally on tour.
What's life on tour like this? Oh, are you traveling with a bus?
Yes. It's different over here. It's a double-decker bus.
Uh-huh.
And in North America, they're just like one floor. But
Oh, so this is fancier.
It's not fancier. It's just different. It's smaller. It's because the bus is split in half, and I'm the only one out of everyone that's staying on the buses that can actually stand without hitting my head on the roof.
Right,
on the roof.
And you do the actual driving as well?
Yeah.
Of the bus?
No.
What do you bring on with you on the bus? Do you have like your Mjukdjur and stuff like that?
My what?
So stuffed animals and PlayStations and.
Yeah, we have PlayStation 2, and we have like a DVD player.
Before you go, I heard that you don't buy that many records. Like a year ago, you hadn't bought any records?
I didn't, you know, have that many records growing up. I did have some that I got for like my birthday and for Christmas and stuff like that. But ever since I've been in doing what I'm doing now, I can kind of get hooked up with records. So I probably have like 500 CDs at home now.
Oh, you have that much? Okay, because we're going to give you a chance to get the some new Swedish music.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, I have some new, very good Swedish music here. that you can win if you participate in my little competition.
Competition?
I'll just show you. These are bands that are making it big in the United States. The Hives, Swedish band. Have you heard of them?
Oh.
Sahara Hot Nights.
I like them.
You like them?
Mm-hmm.
Soundtrack of Our Lives. And the Bransta City Slackers. So these are...
Why is that so funny?
Because they're dressed up as firemen. But these, oh, these are good, and this is more of a joke. And you can win all this if you compete in my hockey competition. Do you want to participate?
Okay.
Okay, give her a big hand. Let's go over here to the hockey competition. Let's go over here. And this is like the hockey start-off position, and if
okay,
you stand there, I will go over here, and we will take this off. And here is a goal. And this is actually a real Wayne Gretzky shirt that he has had on. You put that on, the Canada shirt. And are you left-handed or right-handed?
I'm right-handed.
You're right-handed, then you can choose any club you want.
So.
Here. Yeah. And I also have five pucks right here. It's a little bit too big, isn't it? But Gretzky was bigger than you. So. And if you put one of these into the goal, you will win all of the records.
I'll get the first one in.
Wait a minute.
Dude, I'll hurt you.
There's something missing, right?
I'll hurt you.
Actually, we've arranged, so we have the hockey goalie from the Swedish national women's team. Give her a big hand. Here she is. Lotta Göteson coming in right here. There she is. Wow, look at this. Hey, Lotta. You can hit her as hard as you want. Känns det bra?
Ja, absolut.
Ja, ni ska åka till Peking.
Mm.
Ja, och spela VM om några veckor.
Jajamän.
Ja, och du kommer stå i målet då. Nu ska du stå mot Avril.
Mm.
I'm just explaining the rules to her.
So do I need to shoot from here? Or can
absolutely. You can't dribble.
I can't.
No, you have to shoot from there.
I can't puck handle up to her.
Is that all right? Can she go up to you? Oh, she doesn't care. You can do anything else. Start off by shooting, and we'll see. And not before I blow the whistle.
Okay.
All right. Avril Lavigne, you ready?
Yep.
Kom igen, Lotta. Oh, that was close. Okay, you can dribble if you want to.
Okay,
this is exciting. Avril on the right. Oh, between her legs. You got to remember, this is the national team's.
Okay, let's get this one out of the way.
Yeah. Come on, Avril. Help her out here, everybody. No, no! Yes! Very good. Avril Lavigne, everybody. Congratulations. Here are the albums. Thank you, and thank you. Sporttema blir det här. Det är så jag håller mig i form. Ni som har hängt med under den här programserien vet att Don Bäckman har slutat hos oss. Tomrummet känns stort, men idag så börjar vi ersätta honom med någonting nytt. Vi har nämligen kontaktat den brittiska succéproducenten Tim Hibbins. Och han har fått i uppgift att på sitt personliga sätt porträttera och visa sitt Sverige, eller som han själv uttrycker det, mitt Sverige. Och till sin hjälp så har han en reporter som heter Sasha, och ikväll är det premiär för det första avsnittet. Varsågoda!